just working on some tumblers, and this one I'm gonna play with. I wanted to try the bead method again with the epoxy. Hello. Hey, my favorite Buckeye fans. You guys are too funny. I'm doing well today. How are you? Hey, Corey. I'm gonna do the alcohol ink bead method on this to see how it works as a straight tumbler, so I don't have to deal with a curve. And a lot of people wanted to see a rainbow one, so I thought I would do a rainbow one. And then I got some tumblers I gotta work on. Yeah, Mr. T will be live tonight, so I just thought I would go live while I'm working. Hello, thanks for joining. We're just gonna be working on this tumbler. It's gonna be pretty cool. You're fighting the last leg of COVID. Ugh. Hopefully you'll feel better soon. Hello from Indiana. Hi. We're in Charlotte, North Carolina. Thank you. Awesome. The kids are decorating the yard and the house for Halloween today. Oh, awesome. All right, let's get some epoxy on here. This playlist is hot. I don't even know what I told it to play. Thank you. I have tons of Halloween leggings. It's my favorite holiday. How is everybody today? It's kind of cloudy and yucky here today, so like I've had a slow go this morning. Your friends got married yesterday near me. Oh, how cool. At the Renaissance Festival, that's even better. We've gone to the Renaissance Festival near us here, and it was a lot of fun. We had a lot of fun. I highly recommend if you go, and if you go for the first time, dress up, because everybody does. It's a lot of fun. I know I'm dragging. You're working on tumblers too? Woo-hoo! We'll work together. I knew I was going to have some left over. I'm going to go drop this epoxy in another cup real quick so I don't waste it. So I'll be right back. Working on an alcohol ink tumbler. We're gonna run some beads through it and make that zigzag pattern with some rainbow colors. And then I'm gonna work on smaller tumblers. Thank you. Just using my torch, I'm gonna pop the micro bubbles. Because once you put inks on there, you really don't want a torch, or at least don't torch too much. Because alcohol inks and flames make bigger flames. Okay, I'm just gonna drop some inks on it. And my hair's mad. It's like the washout fade out in this has really been a lot of fun. I'm enjoying it. It's interesting for sure. Not what I expected, but I'm loving it. I have to remember this is a 30 ounce. I have more room. And I always lose my yellow, so I'm gonna make sure I get plenty of yellow. You won't see a whole lot while I'm dropping these inks on, but as soon as I put the white ink on it, it will pop. I'm using Black Bear inks, super saturated in color. I have a random playlist on today, I do. It's crazy, I think it was 90s hits. All right, magic's gonna happen in just a second, guys. I know this looks really boring. You're like, what the hell? Doesn't look like she's doing anything. Just give me 1 second. Last color. All right. Get a little bit of heat. I'm losing my yellow again. That's orange, man. It's bright. I'll add some more yellow back in. I'm getting orange. Orange, orange, orange. Out some more of the colors, get some swirling going on. Thanks for joining. I lose my yellow every time, even when I make more room for it. And it's the prettiest yellow too. Get a little excited with the orange. It's all gonna blend here in a second. right in the, I'm gonna let this set up for just a second, then we're gonna take our beads across it. Hello. I don't know if I ever told you, but my daughter absolutely loved her hydrocephalus tumbler. I know I'm on early. We're getting ready to bead this. That is beautiful. Wish I'm more yellow. I can show you the other two that we did now that they're set and dry. We're gonna do an auction on these. I gotta get the video posted. We're gonna do, our followers wanted to auction these off for charity. And so we're gonna post a video and have you guys help us pick the charity. And then you guys will be able to vote on that video. So I'm gonna try to get that posted today for these two.
Garbage truck hates the garbage truck.
It's quite loud. He's super nice though. Hello, hello. Thank you. I've done my hair a lot of different colors, but this has definitely been my favorite. It was mostly purple and blue with a little bit of pink, but a lot of that pink is starting to pop out. And lighter blue's coming where it was bleached. It's been a minute since I've been on Love Your Hair. Thank you. This is really pretty. The other two, I love the way they turned out. So we're gonna, I gotta put some gloves on so I can clean those beads off. I thought as it would spin, it would lose the zigzag, and it doesn't. You just gotta wait for that epoxy to set up just a tiny bit, like thicken up a little bit. And it's a quick set epoxy. Aw, thank you, I appreciate that. I don't always. I just won't come on live unless I've done something with my at least my face. My hair will throw up, I don't care. I'll show them again in just a second. Let me clean these beads off. Because as we're sitting here, that's drying on the beads. It's epoxy. Try to get them as clean as I can so I can use them again. It's not acrylic paint, it's alcohol inks. In a, like, dripped over epoxy. I did the bloom method. So I started with a black base. I put epoxy on it, quite a bit. You wanna put, like, this is a 30 ounce, I put 30 milliliters on it, and get that epoxy going, and then drop your inks on, and then drop your white on to get those colors to pop, and then let it spin for a minute or two. You wanna watch, if you get any swirling, you wanna start going the other direction, and it'll swirl at the tops and bottoms, not in the middles. So just watch your top and your bottom. I gotta move this over to a more level turner. Drop the inks on, drop the white on, and then once it's set a little bit, go ahead and take your beads and start stringing them through. Y'all are so sweet. I just wanted more yellow to come out. I can't see usernames, guys. I'm so sorry. I can barely read the comments from here. All right, let me grab those other two and I'll show them to you. I used Black Bear inks. Guys, if you guys use alcohol inks, I highly recommend the Black Bear inks. I bought the whole set and trust me, it's worth it. There's 42 colors in there. It's insane the amount of colors. The saturation of color is amazing. You can tell with the red, I put the pink, you know, white over it, and it usually turns pink. But with just a couple more drops of red on top, brought that red back out, nice and bright. And they last a long time. I've been using the, I mean, I use these a lot, and I still have a lot of ink left. Thank you so much for the follow. I appreciate it. We're just working on a alcohol ink. Bead it, zigzag it. I don't know what we're calling it yet. I don't know what they're gonna, I don't know. We'll figure that out. It is a good song. Yeah, I'll show you guys up close here. I just touched it. Good thing I had gloves on. The brand of ink is Black Bear Glitters. They're on here on TikTok as Glitter Dealer BBG. But if you go to blackbearglitters.com, they're amazing. And when I say, I'll give you an idea of how many colors, okay? Colors, you name it. You want a ton of different shades of browns and yellows and peaches and mauves and pinks. Yeah. Yellows, greens, blues. There's tons of choices. And they are pretty much true to the color on the cap. So if you pick out one, it's pretty close to that color on the cap. I haven't used the white yet. I didn't even know there was a white one in there. Dark, bright, vivid colors, light pastel colors. They have them all, and they're amazing. I mean, look at these. If you order, use Thirsty Turtle and get 15% off. Yeah, they're amazing. Like, they're still, you want grays and taupes. You guys are trying to do military tumblers with inks. They're all in here, all of them. They're amazing. Look at all. They're great. So you get this vibrancy. Don't use a ton of ink. It's awesome. All right, I'm gonna move this one over to my level turner. We're gonna move on. I've got some tumblers. I got a couple tumblers I have to glitter. I have a couple that I have to decal, which is gonna be boring, but you guys can keep me company during that. It's gonna be a Peekaboo Fireworks tumbler. I have to do a Milky Way over the prettiest rainbow tumbler you've ever seen. And I mean the prettiest. I'm having it. It's been 4 days and I can't cover it yet. I keep trying to get myself motivated to do the Milky Way on it. Let me move this. All right. I'll show you the two tumblers we did on the live the other day with the beads. I did these on curves. We're going to be auctioning these off for charity. I think the two biggest that came up were breast cancer and battered women's and children, I think. So we're gonna be auctioning these guys off for those charities. We're gonna help you guys pick, you guys are gonna help us pick the charity, you're gonna vote on the charities, and then we're gonna auction them off, and that's where it's gonna go. So I have this, this is the most amazing rainbow tumbler. Glitter rainbow tumbler ever, and I have to cover it with Milky Way, and I'm sad. It's gonna be beautiful, but I'm sad because that is, look at that. Stunning. So we're gonna do some decals, let's do that, because that's, you know, kind of boring, but you can keep me company. I'm working. And then I can bring you in a little closer too, so I can read comments and actually see users. Here. Hi. Isn't that rainbow gorgeous? Oh. This one is going to be a fireworks tumbler. This was all done in glow glitters. So these all are going to glow in the dark. So we're going to put some fireworks on here and then we're going to spray paint the whole cup and then peel the decals off. Doesn't that sound like fun? I go to a bar called the Thirsty Turtle. Oh, wait, cool. We ate at a restaurant called the Hungry Turtle, and then we drank at the bar later at the Drunken Turtle. So we thought, I think we found home. Thank you so much for following. Appreciate it. All right, let's get some decals on this cup. Reading is not my favorite. Decals are not my favorite day. So I'm glad you guys are here to keep me company. Appreciate it. Oh God, I even forgot some of the other inks. Look, there's more. I have them everywhere because I've used them everywhere. What kind of tumblers do I make? I make mostly custom, almost all custom tumblers. I've done some ready to ships, but I'm trying to think. Most of them are on the packing ship table other than the ones that I'm working on. This one's gonna be a fireworks tumbler. I've got all of my videos are on my tumblers that I've made. So if you just check on my page real quick, you'll see a whole bunch. There's like a shit ton. A shit ton. So there's only a handful of designs that I haven't done. Where do I get those colors at? The tube ones. These ones I was just showing you, these are Black Bear alcohol inks. Black Bear glitters. Use Thirsty Turtle for 15% off. There's like 42 different colors, I think. Guys, if I missed a comment or question, just post it again. I will do my best to try to keep up with them. I'm just weeding some little fireworks decals that we're gonna put on here. This glows in the dark. All of the colors glow in the dark. And so it'll be really cool. It'll light up. Can't really see it because it's not dark. It'll light up really cool. How do I get the clientele for customs? I've only done a couple for personal use. I made a bunch of cups that I wanted to make, new styles and designs and techniques that I wanted to do. And when I got really good at them, I started posting them everywhere. And people liked them and they're like, hey, is that available? And I'm like, it sure is. And they're like, I want to buy it. And it just goes from there. You just have to keep posting. Post, post, post. Good afternoon. Hello. Befitting that my music has changed to my, ugh, that decal is rough. I don't have the patience for waiting. So it doesn't come out, whatever. Hello, hello. So yeah, we're just doing some decals, making some fireworks. It's kind of boring. You just got your Cricut, a printer, and an iron. Fantastic. You will find that if you're using an iron to make t-shirts, that one of the first things you will want to do is save up all your money and get a heat press. If you are serious about making t-shirts, you are going to want a heat press. It is worth the money. I burnt the shit out of myself on mine the other day making a shirt, but you will definitely appreciate having a heat press. And I bought, it was like a $200 heat press. It came with a cup attachment, a bunch of attachments, hat attachment, everything. And it's a pretty decent, it's a swivel. I like those a little bit better than the clamshells. It takes up a little less, it takes up more space, but it's nice to be able to just swivel it out. But you don't have to break the bank on a heat press either. Came with a cup and hat, and yep, came with all of it. Now that was a couple years ago. I haven't seen what they're priced at now. I'm gonna put my readers on. I can't see, sorry. Can't see the little lines.
I love
$300 on Amazon. Yeah, I mean, I think mine was like $220 after everything said and done. Welder sleeve, yeah. I don't use my heat press very often anymore, but I've got a bunch of tie-dyes coming, so I kind of brought it back out, pulled it back out, and dumbass me wasn't paying attention, and I went to move the shirt, and... You have the sublimation ink coming. All right, so you're gonna turn your printer into a sublimation printer. That's what I did for one of my printers. I bought a printer specifically to turn into a sublimation. I've tried one sublimation tumbler and I screwed it up so bad. I covered it in glitter and it's still sitting up there. But I will get back to it again. Hey Jazza. Hey Ryan. Surprise! Whoops, I did it again. I'm not gonna get that decal. That's two. It's two. This is getting kind of slow songs. What happened to the good songs? Not that this isn't a good song. It's a good song. Hey baby daddy. Y'all are so cute. So how's everybody's Monday? It's Monday. Monday's just another day of work for me. So is every other day. It's a good song. It's just typically when I'm working, I like something a little more bounce to it. Dakota Boo, how are you? We're just waiting some decals. We're almost done. So we're gonna be putting these on here. It's gonna become a peekaboo. These are glow glitters. I got all those glow glitters from BJsGlitter.com. If you haven't ordered from them, they're amazing. BJsGlitter.com, and you can use Turtle 30 and get 30% off your first order. It only works for your first order. Yeah, something a little more upbeat, something a little more, you know, not all want me to think about my past relationships and be sad. I've been married for 30 years. What past relationships? Do you have the time? Yeah, I've got the 27, I think I have the 2760, maybe the 27, I don't know. I was not happy with the ink that I purchased because it didn't print out. I know it prints dollar and then when you press it, but I tried that and I think the ink was not the best choice for me. All right, let's put some of these decals on here. They're super cute. Thank you very much. Sherry from Broken Leg Vinyl made that for me. And I want you guys to see how amazing this is. I also have a code for there. I think it's Thirsty Turtle. I don't remember. But this beautiful, beautiful tumbler was not glittered. It was not hand glittered. This is a vinyl wrap. Look at that amazing glitter. Okay? This was a vinyl wrap. I watched her do it in 2 minutes. She wrapped the whole cup in 2 minutes. They come like this. In vinyl wrap sheets, and then these are pinstripe, but they're not all even like the same. So you wanna do your own pinstriping, which gives it the depth when you put it on a cup. Look at that sparkle. Looks like it's hand glittered, but it's not. Not hand glittered. Vinyl wrap, look at that. That is vinyl. That's what that is. And then she put the vinyl stripes over it. And that's because I really don't have the patience to hand glitter. I am gonna be hand glittering one of my first cups. It's my Bandit. We're gonna hand glitter it. But as far as vinyl, you can't tell that that's not hand glittered. You can't tell. It's unbelievable. It's a vinyl wrap. So use Thirsty Turtle, and I think it's a 10%. I think it's 10%. I don't remember. forgot I dumped that over.
I didn't pick that up last night. Yeah, people will buy them before you're even done if they see you making them. Don't sell yourself short on those. You should be charging at least $70 for them. At least. If not $80, $90, $100, depending on how much experience you have. But they take a lot of time, so make sure you get paid for your time. From where? It's Broken Leg Vinyl. They're here on TikTok too. But if you go to Broken Leg Vinyl, Sherry's the owner there. She's amazing. She'll even print other color patterns for you. So she'll do custom colors too. It's pretty incredible. All right, let's put some of these fireworks on here. I can't wait to see this like glow in the dark. It's gonna be really cool. I have a fireworks tumbler that I did with glow in the dark and UV changing color vinyl. If you haven't checked that out, it's on my page. It's really cool. I can't do the song either. Alexa, next. Sorry, guys, if I changed your music. This is a good song. Also slow, but it's a good song. Yeah, they sell, most of the people that I know that make them, if I were to refer you to a Tumblr maker, they're charging $90 to $100. And I have a couple I can refer you to. But it's getting more scarce. Because once you've made a handful and then you get a bunch of orders for them, because you will, you'll get a bunch of orders for them if you want to make one. But after you've made 10 or 12 of them, you're kind of over the design and the technique and you're ready to move on to something else. I know I went live early. I'm just working. Oh, you did a glow-in-the-dark birthday party for your son? That sounds so cool. One of, we used to do haunted houses in our front yard, like with tents and walls and actual strobe lights and fog machines. And one of the best acts that we did in there was a glow-in-the-dark. It was all glowing circles on the walls in all different bright colors. And then there was somebody dressed in black that actually had dots all over them and they stepped out at you. Scary as shit, but it was awesome. Everybody's like, oh, this isn't so bad. And then they got really scared. It was pretty funny. You try to peekaboo for the first time and you had a hard time peeling off the vinyl. So what did you use for your top? Did you just do spray paint over it? Did you glitter over it? Did you Mod Podge over it? What was your top piece? Can I make a Selena style? I'm not sure. That's something that you could certainly message me about. I've not made one. I know who she is. She's a beautiful, amazing singer. Very tragic. She's so young. Yeah, my customs are currently closed. They will be opening back up hopefully at the end of this month. We're in the process of moving. I've got my fingers crossed. There's two houses I'm waiting to hear back. So we'd like to move and then open customs, but I may open up a few customs at a time before we move. I just don't want to have 120 customs sitting in my lineup again, and then we're going to move in the middle of that. Thank you. I appreciate that. I love my hair color too. It's been a lot of different colors. My favorite before this I did where it was red, orange, and then yellow, and it was really cool with like flames. But the purple, blue, pink has been my favorite for sure. I usually go red in the wintertime. This is the first time I haven't gone red. Mod Podge with glitter. Okay, so I recommend if you've got decals on there and you're doing a Mod Podge, you need to do... you're going to have to pull your decals before your Mod Podge dries completely, which means it can disrupt your glitter. I would seriously consider maybe trying it don't know. I know how to do glue dots too, so I could find my decals once I glittered it. I used the Tack-It when I did that instead of, I used Tack-It over and over instead of Mod Podge when I did it over my Peekaboo, only because the Tack-It, when it dries, it's sticky. And so to me, it was easier to remove the decals, get the glitter stuck, and then remove decals. So you might want to try Tack-It. Or water your Mod Podge down a little bit. It may be too strong sticking. New Year, do I sell the glitter behind you? I don't. That's my personal glitter collection. And that's not even all of it. I'm actually reaching out to you guys to help us out. I think we've narrowed it down to Gatorade and vitamin water, right? I want to build a new glitter wall. And I was going to do PVC pipe, but I know that's going to also be heavy. Because I'm going to need it. I've got about probably 12 to 1400 glitters. And I really, really, we're thrifty journal tumblers. We really like to try to emphasize on not having plastic in the oceans and protecting our sea turtles and that kind of stuff. So we're going to do plastic bottles and we're going to recycle them. And we're going to ask you guys to help out and help recycle some bottles, vitamin waters or Gatorade bottles. Clean them out, pull the labels off, and we're going to have a P.O. box you can ship them to. And you can help us build an entire glitter wall out of plastic bottles. I think it would be a lot of fun. And it'll make me feel better. Oh, I love this decal. This one's pretty. It's one of my favorite fireworks, too. So this is all going to become a peekaboo. This is all glow-in-the-dark glitter. So we're just going to keep going around and keep decaling. Isn't that an awesome idea? It's just, I couldn't possibly, I mean, it would take me a long time to probably get together 1,200 bottles. But, and they would be super light to ship. You probably could ship them first class because they're just light plastic. And then we'll cut them down and for the size of the bottles, and we'll connect them all together and they'll get hung up on the wall and we'll put our glitter in them. Where do I get my glow in the dark glitter? My glow in the dark glitter, this is from bjsglitter.com. They look very pastel. They're very pastel looking. So make sure you do plenty of at least two coats. And then once you get epoxy on it, it'll brighten up. Those are the exact same colors that are right here. So that yellow brightens way up when it gets under epoxy. So this is the purple, the blue, and the pink. And those are all from BJ's. And you can use Turtle 30 for 30% off your first order. Thank you for following me. I appreciate that. If you're not already following me, make sure you do give me a follow because we go live at least 3 times a week with making tumblers with me. And then on Monday evenings, we do Men Who Craft Mondays with Mr. T. He usually has a guest jump on with him and they do something artsy, something crafty, whatever. We started that for kind of a bullying campaign. We've got a younger member in our group with his mom, and he got picked on and bullied for liking to craft. And we wanted to show him that men craft too. So we do that on Monday evenings, 8:30 p.m. Eastern time. So stop back tonight, give us a shout out. You'll hear me reading comments for Mr. T, which is usually what he does for me. Can I pull that off? I miss this one too. Did anyone come here and ask about an alternative to epoxy? I have tried alternatives to epoxy. Crystalac is one of them. I've tried it. It didn't work for me only because the time my order volume wasn't conducive to the amount of time it takes. I've known several tumbler makers, though, very successfully make the transition over to Crystalite products. Hello, hello. You follow me? Awesome. Thank you so much. I appreciate that. I use the, I have an allergy to epoxy, and so you pretty much name it, I've tried it. When I had to go on steroids for almost 6 months to get over the allergy, I realized that I can't keep doing this to myself. Mr. T took over all of the epoxying for me, so that I could heal up and get better. And then working with my doctor, we started to try them one at a time and see if I was getting reactions to all of them or what. And so after trying, I'm pretty sure I've tried everything. I've got two or three that I have the least amount of, it is a surprise life, the least amount of reaction to. Meaning if I don't get it on my skin, I'm usually pretty good. I broke out a little bit recently because I wasn't careful and got some on my arms. What am I gonna spray paint on the cup? I have to relook at the decal. I think it's gonna go black because I think it's gonna glow in the dark. I think it's gonna glow in the dark best with a black top coat. And I also think that the fireworks will stand out more in the daylight, being that they're kind of more of the lighter colors, with a black base. So it's probably going black. Is Mr. Turtle still epoxy for you? He does when I need the extra help. He will jump in and do that for me, absolutely. He does a lot of the cleaning for me. I do notice that the epoxy dust from sanding, even with wet sanding, does irritate my skin a little bit. So he does all of the cleaning in that for me too. But yeah, I've been pretty good with the two epoxies that I've been using. Mostly it's just the one. I haven't had the other one for a while. And so I just try to be really careful. Yeah, I think it's going to be really pretty. I think it's going to be really, really pretty. I don't know if I want two more of those. Let's see if I can get some of these littler ones in there. They're pretty. How are you today? What epoxies do I use? The one that I use probably most of the time, because I haven't had the other one around for a little while. Shoot, I didn't mean to do that. Well, that was just silly. I guess I'll piece it together. Is KS Resin Liquidy Split. And I've also, they have the new UV, extra UV. So it's good for top coats and final coats. And then I use the regular Liquidy Split too. I like the fast set epoxies. Those work. They work for me a lot better. It drove me enough if I had to wait for epoxy to dry. It drove me crazy. I don't know if I could handle it. There are little pieces coming off everywhere. So this is going to be super cute. They're going to be such a pain in the butt to peel off. For sure. All these little itty bitty tiny pieces. I don't actually mind that part so much, which is weird. How many of y'all know this song because you've heard it on the radio way before Rock Band? And then how many of you only know this song from Rock Band? I said it way too fast. I'm sorry. KS Resin Liquidy Split. They have the newer Ultra UV is the one that I use. I've been using since it came out. The other Liquidy Split, it doesn't have the extra UV in it. I was using before that, but I wasn't using it as my final coat. I was using Glitter Craze Platinum for my final coat. But they're having a hard time getting it back in stock. So we're just, you heard it from Rock Band, right? I'm spoiling you. Who's spoiling you? Me? Well, you're not going to get to see me live tonight. Mr. T's on tonight. What is this song? What's the name of this song? I can't remember. Something, something, son, something. What's the name of the song, folks? Alexa, what's the name of this song?
This is Say It Ain't So from Weezer.
Say It Ain't So from Weezer. I like Weezer. I don't want to have too much like blank black space since the cup itself is a fireworks cup. So I'm really trying to load these suckers on there. You knew it before Rock Band because you're old? Me too. It's okay. Reminded me how much I liked the song when Rock Band came out. And I can nail it on the drums too. Oh, she just went and saw Weezer in September? That's freaking amazing. That is awesome. All right, what do I have left? I've got a spot here. I think it's going to end up being this one, and I think we're going to run it over the bottom. So we got a little bit of fireworks on the bottom, too. My transfer tape has been used, I think, too much. We'll see if this even works. Come on. I may have to hand place some of them. Oh, we got all but one. We're good. Stand up to do this. Sorry. Okay, sorry. I had to stand up to do that part. I can't get it on straight and try to bend it to get those decals down. Oh, we got them. Good playlist. Man, killing it with these songs today. Now, if it can stick to the cup, that would be awesome. Also known on Rock Band by many and not the original. Come on. Doesn't like that edge. Of course it doesn't. Here we go. All right. We're gonna do the same thing on this side. So I need a new piece of tape. Try to reuse it as much as I can, but I know this song is awesome. And he has to cut them. Scissors are so gnarly. No, I didn't. What? I'm sorry. Did I miss something? What I miss? What station is playing? It is 90s top hits on Amazon Music. What did I miss? typically the regular UV, it's not always recommended as your top coat. Means all epoxies can amber over time, but it just means it doesn't have the additional UV protections in there to keep it from yellowing as much as some of the other epoxies. So you just, I mean, all epoxies like that. So they've added the new UV, extra UV in it, which is awesome. So usually those ones are the ones that you, unless it's a dark colored cup. But it's recommended to get the higher UV when you're doing it as your final coat. I hope that answered your question. There we go. All right. So we got our decals everywhere. We're gonna spray paint over it and then we'll remove the decals and that will show through. And I think it'll be really stinking cute. I wanna... Yeah, that's the one. This is another slow song. Great song, it's so slow. Alexa, next. I gotta clean up my mess or I can't move forward. I gotta pick my box up. It was a Customaholics question that I had missed. Shoot, sorry. I'm looking, hold on. What is the difference between the UV? Was that the one that I missed? Oh, you're new to cup making and you watch and you can, but you work in school and you miss some lives. I upload all of my lives that when I go on TikTok and I go live, it gets recorded. I upload them all to YouTube. So you can look up Thirsty Turtle Tumblers on YouTube and watch any of them. The question you asked was her question. Okay. Yep. And I answered it. Okay. Good. Good. I just don't want to leave anybody hanging. Did I just stick my hand in it? I did. Alrighty. We're going to spray paint this beautiful cup black. Anything that I get that I touch is sticky, it drives me nuts because I'm like, oh my god, is it epoxy? I think that was Mod Podge. Where's Mr. T? He's working. I mean, he's doing his consulting work. I can't find it here in Belgium, which you can't find our lives, you can't find the YouTube channel, you can't find Mod Podge. What can't you find in Belgium? Both my glitter companies ship overseas, so if you're in the UK and you need glitter, Blackbird Glitters will ship, and so will BJ's Glitter. So if you guys are trying to get some glitter, I know it's hard to get some glitter over in the UK sometimes, they'll ship. Hey, Dusty. Crystallac. Yeah, I've tried Crystallac. You just have to have patience with it. It takes several coats, several layers. It's very thin, it's very fast, and it's very easy. It just takes lots of layers. I was like, the time I was trying to do it, it was right at the Christmas holiday, and I had like 360 orders, and I just wasn't able to try to make that switch at that time. So Mr. T jumped in and did all of my epoxy. All right, let's get this cup sprayed. Thank you. What other tumblers are you going to see me work on? I'm working on this one. I'm going to do the Milky Way over the rainbow. I have a purple one that I have to glitter. And I have a Monsters, Inc. inspired one that I have to glitter. Aw, thank you. I appreciate that. When making white decor tumbler cups, which resin should I use? I'm afraid over time it will yellow. They're all gonna yellow over time. I mean, it's gonna happen. But find something that's got a high UV. That's why I like the KS Resin Liquidy Split. Alumalite just came out with a high UV facet as well. I'm trying to think of some of the other ones that have it. Glitter Crazes Platinum is high UV. I think the Tumbler Poxy, the Swift Poxy, the new one that came out is high UV. I haven't tried the new one, I tried the old one. I'm not sure, I'm sorry. You can buy the parts and make it yourself if you're handy. Can you make one with a rotisserie? Yes, you can. There's a ton of YouTube videos if you need to, if you want to make your own Turner. Absolutely. I bought the $25 ones from Amazon when I first started. And I had like 12 of them at one point. And then I upgraded to my MH Turner. And I love those. I love the magnetic arms to them, so I don't have to screw anything on or off, and I can move it from one turner to another without having to take off the whole thing. In my experience, how long? It depends on the epoxy. Some of them will yellow in a couple of weeks, some of them will yellow in a couple of months, some of them will yellow in a couple of years. It just really depends on your epoxy. All right, I'm gonna throw my mask on because I'm using aerosol spray paint and my lungs don't like it. So I'm gonna protect up. Get my hair out of the way. Hi, buddy, what are you doing? The cat just woke up. Let me tell you how awesome yesterday was. I got a nap, which is unheard of. And I came downstairs from my nap, and all of my kids were in the kitchen. All three of my kids, their spouses and significant others, and my two grandchildren and my nephew, my whole, everything I love in my life is all in the kitchen. Tom was in there. And I just stood on the steps for a minute and just took it all in, because it doesn't happen very often when your kids grow up. So it's pretty incredible. Always makes me sad to see such a pretty base covered up. So we're gonna let that dry, and then we're gonna pull those decals off and expose that beautiful glitter. Epoxy, so give me just a minute. We're gonna epoxy and do the Milky Way. Glad you guys are here for moral support, because it's gonna kill me. It's gonna kill me to do that to this cup. So just hang in there with me for a minute. Up to me, you motherfuckers, stop coming up to me with your hands out, looking up to me like you want something free.
my last CD was that you wouldn't come with me. But now that I got you through the company, everybody wanna come to me like it was some disease, but you won't get a crumb from me. I'm from the streets of I told them all. I'm no gangsters, who do you think y'all wear them all? Now you wanna run around talking about colors like I ain't got you.
Try to get the cup above the comments so you guys can see it. Alright. Gloves. How did we just go from Eminem? What? What? This 90s. That'll tell that the 90s. And this gorgeous. I gotta cover it up with white ink. It's literally giving me anxiety. I seriously have thought about just restarting it. But I thought that one's gonna look badass too. And then I gotta cover one of them up with ink, so I might as well just make it this one. It's what the customer wanted. I know. Alexa, next. Don't get me wrong, I like some country. I just don't wanna hear it all the time. I gotta mix some epoxy. Get a coat on there. Sit down while I do that, because standing sucks sometimes. Tired today. Another one. Good song. It's slow. Damn. The hell, 90s? Was it all ballads in the 90s? Did I not remember there being some hair bands and stuff? Some grunge? Did you just do that? It jumped out of my hand. It's weird. It doesn't want to cover this cup either. It's like, no, don't make me do it. When are we moving? Hopefully within the next couple weeks. Nope, didn't see anything, right? Just never happens. Y'all are too funny. I keep getting, look at, see, I got epoxy on me again. This is what happens. Oy, oy, oy. Think of your baby wipes. You ever get epoxy on your hands and you can't get the sticky off even after washing them? Put some lotion on your hands and then rub it in and then rinse it off. Like, not rub it in, but like wash them like you're washing your hands with lotion. It'll take the sticky right away. Not yet. Not a house yet. One of those days. All right, I'm gonna put some on here first, and then we're gonna mix up our white to do our Milky Way. You want a little bit of epoxy on your cup to be able to get that Milky Way moving around a little bit. You don't want a whole lot of movement, but you also don't want it to not like glide around the cup a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
They're so well blended. I know, they're gorgeous. We did this on a live the other day. We glittered, spray painted it, and then glittered it. I'm gonna try to pull the video and cut that piece out, make a video of it. I just haven't had the time. Do I ever have problems getting epoxy to stick to parts of the glitter? Is it repelling your epoxy or is it soaking in to your glitter? It kind of matches my hair. It does a little bit, huh? If you add if you add acrylic to your epoxy, the more you put in, the stringier the epoxy gets. So I try to start off with just a little tiny bit in there at first, just until I get the consistency that I want. It's repelling. What are you applying your glitter with that the epoxy is repelling from it? It's gotta be whatever you're using. It's Mod Podge, Tack, it's something. But those shouldn't repel epoxy. They're usually used to help from repelling epoxy. Okay. Get the air bubbles, the micro air bubbles, and then it's giving it a little bit of heat too, to kind of help it loosen up and move around a little bit. I gotta do it. Ugh, this is gonna kill me. Okay, customer's gonna love it. I just have to remind myself. Customer already loves it. She's gonna love it even more. I know it. Okay. We got this. Oh gosh. Okay, it's done, right? I'm just gonna just go with it then. Okay. Sorry guys, I will come back and hit comments in just a second.
Still, I don't think I've taken a breath yet. Not hating it now. It's just
beautiful.
Oh, I did not want to cover that, but it is gorgeous.
Hi, Envious.
Hello.
Daza's in here. Dusty's in here.
I know, they've been hanging out with me. All right. I like it, but I really liked it without it. But I like it.
Oh,
I like it.
Julia Jones, you can just flip-flop back and forth.
It's pretty. I kept it kind of subtle.
Dana Borella, what's in the mixture?
Just white acrylic paint and epoxy. I'm going to babysit it for a few just to make sure I get any swirlies on the end because I want to keep that diagonal-like flow going. That's why I use quick sets so I don't have to babysit it for too long. You were holding your breath? Me too! Pretty soon we'll start taking orders again. I love the heck out of that. One color glitter on. No, this is all. We ombre'd the shit out of this tumbler on our live the other day. We spray painted our base first and then we glittered each color on it and ombre'd the hell out of it. I know, right? Yeah, I don't like big globs. I don't mind them thicker as long as they're kind of in a swirly type shape. I'm not taking orders right now, but we will be taking them pretty soon. I'm gonna try to start doing like maybe a fun tumbler on every live that'll be available to purchase. My tummy's growling, I'm gonna get some food. It's pretty. I'm liking it. The bottom looks gorgeous too. Little swirl. Watch what I'm touching. I know, it's super pretty. It was so hard to cover that up, but it's pretty. I like it. I would have been perfectly happy if it were my cup just the way it was before. But I do like it. The Milky Way gives it a dimensional look because it's kind of floats on top, so it's kind of neat. It looks good, but it was painful to watch. I know, I'm sorry if I made that look painful. Mr. T, what's for lunch?
Sausage, biscuits, and gravy.
Sausage, biscuits, and gravy. We had Baby Turtle's birthday party last night, and we did a whole entire breakfast bar. Mr. T did all the breakfast, but I shouldn't say we. He did it all. French toast, scrambled eggs, biscuits and gravy, bacon, scrambled eggs. It was so good.
Mushrooms,
cheese. Yeah, I think with, it doesn't say, the owner didn't say whether they wanted a name. So I don't think there's a name on it. This is for Miss Megan Rose. What is that one? Oh, I haven't epoxied it yet. Maybe it's epoxied. All right, I'm gonna move this to the other turner so I can get it level. Oh, thank you. I appreciate that. Jen, I'm going to message you about my tumbler. My daughter ordered it in April. Absolutely. Shit. April tumbler? Yeah. It should be either coming up soon if it was a mix-up. But if you message me, we'll take care of it. What are some of my favorite cups to make? This is one of my new ones that I'm gonna be hand glittering today. It's our Blue Bandit method. I haven't decided how I want to glitter it though. I love the idea of rainbow, but I was almost thinking keeping it monochromatic, maybe in a bunch of different shades of purple. But it's really cool. Started off black, we put rubber bands over it, spray paint it white, and then took the rubber bands off. And then we're gonna hand glitter each of these little geometrical shapey line sections. I think it'll be cool. That one was really fun to make. I like to make a lot of different tumblers. Repetitiveness can bore me, so having a lot of different things is cool. It'd be perfect. I love the last rubber band one. Yeah, I've got that one here too. Where's that?
Somebody asked why they're not for sale. They're so good at this.
Oh, I do sell my tumblers. We're getting ready to move, and I didn't want to have. I usually carry about 120 custom orders at a time, and I didn't want to have a bunch of custom orders and people waiting for it while we packed up an entire workshop and moved it. So we kind of cut them off so I could get them down and out and get them all shipped, because these are the last like 25 or so already are getting worked on. Those will all be out the door and shipped. So we did a ready to ship sale. And now I'm just making some fun stuff while I'm working on the last 25. And I'll probably have a few available for purchase when we make them. It looks like a mummy. We did do a mummy with the dish soap drizzle. We had those in our ready to ship sale. All right, let me get this tumbler over on the other turner so it doesn't get all bonky. It is really pretty. I'm not upset. I'm not upset anymore. That was so full of epoxy. That was gross. They did go back and had a little run-in with it, and that 4-week-old, 6-week-old, tiny little bit of kitten kicked their asses, scratched them all up, and got away. Neither one of them were, sober enough to realize that maybe they should take a towel or a blanket or a sweatshirt or something to get a hold of a cat with claws. Natural born killers in that set of 20. It is. Sure is. Yeah, I've done, there's only a couple tumbler styles or techniques that I haven't done, and it's mostly because I haven't gotten an order for one. I shouldn't say that, because sometimes I get orders for tumblers, and then I just make them different. I don't want to make the same pencil cup as everybody else. I don't want to make the same whatever. So I try to be different every time I make a tumbler. I try to switch it up. I'm going to have to go wash my hands, guys, because I got epoxy on me way too much today without going in and getting it all cleaned off. I appreciate it. Yeah, if you want to see some of the other tumblers I've made, go check out some of my videos on my page. Almost all my tumblers are on there. There's one on there for the ready to ship sale. It shows all the cups that we did. It was pretty cool. Next, we're going to do a glitter cup. So we're going to work on that. But I'm going to go wash my hands. I'm going to run in the house and go wash my hands really, really good. You guys figure out what that's going to be. I mean, I told you guys earlier, but I'll be right back. Guys, if you happen to stick around with me, that's awesome. It's only going to take me a few minutes to run the house, wash my hands. If any of the moderators hang out, just let everybody know. I'll be right back. And we'll get back to work. I'll be right back. See you in a minute. About that. Hey, Sean. You guys are awesome. Apparently I go away with 103 people in here and I come back to 113. Maybe I should go away again. I don't know how my ego is going to handle that. I'm just kidding.
All right, let's get this one done.
All right, we're gonna spray paint this guy first. We're gonna be doing green at the top, blue at the bottom. Then it's gonna get some purple spots in the blue part. And then it's got some flowers up on the green part. Did you figure out what we're making? Hello! That was Ladybug. I actually had to close TikTok out completely and reopen. It sucked. All right. Got our ombre happening. Using my wet spray paint to start my first layer of glitter. BJ's, and now I'm doing the Colorado Skies. It's the iridescent from Black Bears. And since this paint's already probably close to dry, I'm going to use clear gloss as my adhesive for my blue glitter. So when I'm trying to start my ombre blend, I focus the spray paint here at this spot and let that overspray hit. And then when I drop my glitter, I'm aiming about a half inch or an inch higher than that. So it's just gonna cascade down and hit where it's sticky, and that's what's gonna stick. Okay? It's just our first layer. We're gonna go in with a second coat. All right, drive safe, Angie. Mr. C, you have to feed Jen as she crafts. As soon as this cup's done, I'm actually gonna stop. We're gonna take a lunch break. So I'm just working on that spraying right above my line so I can bring my green back down one more time, okay? Giving it all a little bit because I want the glitter to stick all over the top. Okay, starting up here and then dropping my glitter down. Letting it cascade and collect where it's sticky. Okay, so it starts that blend. And then we'll do another coat of the blue and we should be good to go.
So take the photographs and still frames in your mind.
Alexa, next. Man, I need some songs that's got some music that's pumped up. You're taking a nap instead of lunch. Alexa, next. All right, Garth Brooks will work. That's pretty. don't know why you guys are seeing like almost a silver through here. It's just actually where the colors have blended. Pretty cool. All right, now I'm gonna seal it, let it dry, and then I'll do a flood coat of epoxy. Actually, I'll let this dry and I'll come back and I'll do my purple spots. Then I'll do the flood coat. I'm gonna let this dry. I'm gonna go have lunch. When I come back, I'll be hand painting some purple spots on there. And I can answer any questions you have before I go. If there was a white glitter, I have a ginormous bottle of my favorite glitter. It's over there, right? Yeah. It's Don't Be Salty by Black Bear Glitters. It is the prettiest white under epoxy. It is stunning. Stunning. Where did they all come from? There's like 50 birds just landed in that little tree. They're all little tiny, tiny birds. Are they migrating? They're coming for a rest. They're little. They're like finches or something. Like tiny. That was the coolest thing I've ever seen. I'm actually amazed. So we have, it's just a little tree. It's not even a big tree. That was so cool. Wow, I had no idea I keep using the devil's glue. Oh, to do your glittering? I don't use Mod Podge unless I'm doing like a multicolor, like next to each other, like stripes and stuff. I'll use Mod Podge for that. But no, I prefer using my gloss paint or the epoxy method. I just try not to use the epoxy method unless I have to. Some designs are better with it because it's epoxy. You got it. Thanks, Cindy. I appreciate that. Yeah, hopefully at the end of the month, we'll be opening at Customs. I'm going to try to start doing like a cup for purchase. Each live will be available. How long does it take for Mod Podge usually to dry? Depends on the environment that you're in, but about an hour or so. About an hour. Clear gloss spray paint takes 10 minutes. Man, I hate unpacking after going to Disney. Unpacking from any vacation sucks. Of course I ship to Mississippi. I ship all over the United States and several countries. The Green Machine. I think we're gonna go with Shelly. You're gonna put eyelashes on her. All right, guys, I'm gonna go grab some lunch. I may jump back on for a little bit just to put these spots on, and then Mr. T will be on. I gotta help him get ready. Well, I don't have to help him get ready, but I have to get my space cleaned up so he can do his live tonight. Yeah, just check out our lives. I think I'm gonna start doing at least one cup for a purchase while I'm working on all the others. Alrighty, y'all, if I missed any messages, feel free to shoot me a private message or you can email us. He goes live on Monday nights for Men Who Craft Mondays. So it'll be tonight, 8:30 p.m. All right, guys, thanks for hanging out with me today. Have a good night and we'll see you. I may jump back on. If not, you'll see Mr. T on live tonight and I'll be with him. Have a good night, guys. Thanks.